on, hatchlings. Let's go trick-or-treating.
Oh! I hope we get lots of candy tonight.
I sure hope we will, Madison.
Boom! Ah! Hey, Mo!
You should have seen the look on your face!
I'm ready for the chicken and the treating!
Looks like everyone's ready. Let's go and... I'll get it.
Trick or treat!
Nice costumes, you guys. Here's some candy.
Thanks!
You're welcome, Isabella. You look cute in your princess costume.
Thank you! Your costume is pretty sweet, too!
Hey, Tiffany, if you don't mind me asking, is it okay if we join your trick-or-treating group over here?
Not at all. Welcome aboard.
All right, spooktacular!
Now, let's go trick-or-treating.
Yay!
Trick-or-treat!
Aw, how cute.
Thanks!
Trick-or-treat!
Smell my feet!
Gross.
Trick-or-treat!
Give us sweets!
And what do we say?
Please?
Good. Here you go.
Thank you! I think I'm candy heaven!
Come on, hatchlings. It's getting late. Let's go to bed.
Aww. Wait, there's one house we have not done yet.
Weird. I never seen this before.
The house gives me chills!
Cool! A haunted house!
Okay!
I don't think that place is safe.
Why not?
Because that might be the mansion of the Black Alchemist!
The what?
The Black Alchemist! You don't know who he is?
Who's the Black Alchemist?
According to what I've heard, the Black Alchemist lived here long ago, before Colorful Island got its name. Legend says that this mansion used to belong to him. He was a hawk named Maximilian, and he was the only one who knew how to use black magic back then. He tried to share his findings with the other birds, but nobody ever listened to him. Every bird thought he was weird and crazy. It is said that one night, he got so angry at the other birds for always being left out that he used his black magic to cast a terrible spell at them, destroying their whole village!
Now that's epic!
No, it's not! It's horrible!
Anyways, the village birds fought back, and they locked Maximilian in his home. And a witch, who also lived in the same village, cursed his home to disappear in the day, but to appear at night. Legend says that whoever enters his home will get attacked by his black magic and never come out!
Ah! Scary!
I relax, it's just a legend. I'm going in!
Wait, no!
Oh, it's you, Maddie. What are you doing here?
I came here to warn you. The Black Alchemist is really angry tonight.
Why?
This is the night they cursed and locked him in his home. Please be careful. He may be a ghost, but his magic is still powerful.
Okay, I'll be careful. Hey! Guys? Hello? Where are you guys? Madison? Enrique? Wade? Where is everyone?
You!
Who are you?
Someone you should not have messed with.
Are you the Black Alchemist?
Die!
Eek! I'll take that as a yes!
Tiffany?
Enrique! I'm so glad to see you! Where is everyone else?
I don't know! We were all together looking for Wade, and then the Black Alchemist came and attacked us all! After that, we all scattered to different areas of this mansion!
Oh no! We need to find him, quick!
So, he's on your side, huh? I'm guessing the children are also your allies.
Yes, they're with us.
We just want to find them and...
Silence, witch!
Dad, crud!
I will not let you or any one of your allies mess with me ever again.
Stand back, Tiffany!
Ah-yah!
Oh, right, he's a ghost. Run!
Phew! That was close.
Tiffany, why is he so angry at you? Why does he think you're a witch?
I don't know. All I did was come inside, and he immediately attacked me.
Strange.
Don't you think you could get away from me that easily?
Leave us alone!
Don't worry. I'll call Maddie so she can distract him. No!
Looks like it's all up to us. Get ready to fight!
Already ahead of ya. Give us your best shot.
If you insist.
Meanwhile...
Wait! Oh, this is impossible! We've been looking for him everywhere! We rocked every hall, checked every room. I want to leave!
Well, we haven't checked that room at the end of the hall!
Shall we? It looks creepy!
Yeah, no. I'ma head out! You open it!
Hey! Why me?
Because you have protagonist armor! Now open it!
I got you all good!
What? How could you?
How could I not? You gave me a chance and I took it!
What the heck are you doing here, Wade?
Oh, I'm just checking out this room. It's like a lab or something. You guys should come inside. It looks really cool!
We need to leave now, Wade!
Aww, do we have to? Fine, but I am totally coming back here. Wait, Madison, you have to look at this!
Wade, we don't have time for this!
If I'm correct, I think this is the witch. She looks like your mom!
That does look like my mom! She looks so weird, haha! guys, where are the adults?
Ah!
Oh no, Daddy!
That must be them! We should go there and help them!
Pinky power!
Your colorful magic is powerful, but not powerful enough!
Wait!
It's not a witch!
So you're a daughter. Well then, might as well get rid of you too.
No!
Stop! Look at this picture. This is the witch, right? Take a closer look and compare them. They're not the same!
You're right. I've been seeking revenge on the wrong person. My deepest apologies to you all. I thought your friend here was the witch that cursed me here.
It's okay. Everyone makes mistakes, Mr.
Maximilian. My name is Maximilian.
I'm Tiffany, and these are my friends, and my daughter Madison.
It is a pleasure to meet you all.
Can I ask you something?
Of course.
Back there, you said something about my powers not being powerful enough. Is there a way I can become stronger?
Yes, I would teach you how, but I can't exactly leave my home. However, wait here.
Are you sure you want to learn from this guy? I mean, he just straight up almost killed us!
Like I said, everyone can make mistakes. Plus, didn't you say he was the first one to ever use color magic? I bet he knows how many spells that I don't. Also, I want to be able to defend myself and protect Madison against the others as strong as him.
I found it! These are the notes I made back when I was alive and still studying color magic. You should be able to find ways of becoming stronger with this.
Ooh, this is perfect. Thank you.
It's the least I can do after giving you such a big scare.
I'm sorry, but can we leave now?
Of Of course, you are free to go.
Thank you, Maximilian.
Also, just one more thing. Happy Halloween!
Yeah! Happy Halloween!
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We got some work to do now. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We need some help from you now. Come on, Scooby-Doo, I see you. Pretending you got silver. You're not fooling me, cause I can't see the way you shake and shiver. You know we got a mystery to solve, so Scooby-Doo, be ready for your act. Don't hold back. And Scooby-Doo, if you come through, you're gonna have yourself a Scooby snack. That's a fact. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, here are you. You're ready and you're willing. If we can count on you,
Fred, I think we just need a break. It's just nonstop.
That's the point of our job. We have to keep on going, no matter how many weirdos in costume there are.
I agree with Fred. It's our job. I mean, it's our job to solve perplexing mysteries. Not that it's our job to agree with Fred.
Well, that might as well also be our job, considering how this conversation is going. Right, Scoob?
Yeah, that's right, Reggie.
Are we really still arguing over if we are going to go on a vacation? I thought the answer was obvious by now. Just 1 week, Fred. The world isn't going to collapse without us.
Fine. But if you're so insistent, do you have any idea on where you want to go?
Preposterous Island?
Where?
Like, you don't know about Preposterous Islands? It has the best fast food restaurants on the earth!
Yeah, and the best buffets!
Of course, that's what you two are concerned about. I know about an art museum there. I find it actually quite interesting that perfectly crafted sculptures from the past are stored there. Apparently, they're worth a lot. The island is also known for being the first island globally to ever fully accept birds and pigs coexisting.
Fine. I guess we'll go. But you all have to help pack for the road trip. This is gonna be one long trip. Dang, we're out of gas. Shaggy Scoob, are there any more gas tanks left in the back? Why did I even ask? Looks like we're pushing the mystery machine to the nearest gas station.
Just call a rental pickup, Fred.
I only have enough money for snacks and administration for the museum, Velma. Rental isn't an option.
Wait, I remember finding a really cool trick that you can do with cars to get them to move without gas.
Wait, really?
Yeah, just let me get in the driver's seat.
Finally, my robot is complete. Once this carnage is released, nobody will be able to stop me from tearing this place down. Soon this entire island will be mine. I'll own everything and everyone. I'll make them fear and respect me. And my plan will naturally fall into place. Step one is now in motion.
looks like we gotta be quiet about moving everything in. And Scooby, I think you might have to go over... there! They look friendly.
I'm not sure about this anymore.
Wow, Velma, you were right! This place is amazing! There's so much to see!
It wasn't the top tourist attraction in 2019 for nothing, Fred. Now, there's something I want to check out. The Golden Egg of 1786. It's one of the most expensive relics to
What's going on?
So you're trying to tell me that this egg from almost 300 years ago turned into a drone, flew around, and bubbled the entire museum?
That's exactly what I saw. Honest, on the Lord.
Riddle me this. How does a stone egg turn into a weapon of mass destruction?
It's clearly a replica. What else could have caused that destruction?
You're heading to the slammer.
Wait, what? Why me?
Considering how much you would leisurely know about this egg, you must be the culprit. And there's no security evidence since everything got destroyed, so we gotta pin the blame on someone. Ain't that right, number two?
Yep. We want change!
What the heck are they doing?
Demanding change. Ever since the destruction of the museum occurred, they want a new police force and a new government. Your run's come to an end, it seems.
But how? How did someone manage to do this? Level an entire building? What's next?
What about the false arrest of Harvey?
Excuse me, who? Attention, citizens of Preposterous Island. I see your anger towards me. I see my flaws about how I told the police to handle this. But this isn't their fault. Lord knows what could have caused that.
Ha! Idiots! I just don't get it. We all know that someone blew up the hall and the museum got torn down. They're in the same time period, so clearly, this is a planned attack.
It seemed that this heavy destruction was caused by many people. I don't think that we'd be able to track them down.
Like, what makes you say that?
Do you realize the amount of wreckage that was in the span of 2 days? Nobody could pull that off alone.
Hey, I hear that you're solving mysteries here now. Huh, it's kind of fun to see my favorite birds in real life. May I inspect the egg? Look for clues? You know, I'm really good at this kind of stuff.
Well, personally, I...
Sure, I don't see why not. Any intel that you can give is good.
Thanks, Velma. It seems to be very intricate and outdated. These wires look like they were soldered 20 years ago. Whoever made this must be decently old and be really good at pyrotechnics. I see the mechanism for a flamethrower in there.
I'm sure this will be a hum.
Thank you, Nikki, for your help. This has an insight on the person's age and profession. With this, we can systematically run through all of the citizens who meet this requirement.
Thanks, Velma. I'll be on my way now.
Fred, you almost took away a potential lead. Do you have any idea how determinational that would have been to this case?
Oh, yeah. Well, where are we going to find a guy in his 50s who's a pyrotechnician?
Having an obscure lead is better than having none, Fred. Keep your mouth shut.
Velma, you gotta not be so mad at Fred. Like, I get it's hard to do that, but you have to hold on, no matter how much stupid stuff he did.
You're right, Shaggy. I shouldn't have been so harsh on him. I guess I'm just so tired of this all. We've been solving mysteries nonstop, and at the moment, we get a chance to relax. Nothing comes out of it. I'm just sick of it. I miss the fun that was put into these mysteries. I innocent back then.
Velma, if you don't feel the drive to do this, that's completely fine. You can take a break whenever you need to. It's a lot of work to put on you, considering that you're the brains of us all. I get that. It's important to you to relax and take some time for yourself.
Thanks, Shaggy. It means a lot.
And I would like to personally think that I hold enough skill and wit to be mayor. I have a university degree in engineering. This means that I can build security systems and prevent tragedies similar to the two last devastating losses that we have experienced. I am very prepared for whatever this great island has to show, and I'll be ready for when it strikes.
Wait. He's an engineer? I'm sure it's just a coincidence that he's old enough to have made circuits that look like they did in the A. No. No, it's not. It has to be him. Who else could it be? I need to let the gang know. But Velma's probably still mad at me.
What are you talking to yourself about now, Fred?
That guy, running for mayor. He's an engineer.
So what?
Daphne, we still have a big mystery to solve. And I think I know who destroyed the museum. It has to be him.
And you're still focused on this at 2 in the morning because...
Justice has to be served. That teen got put in prison for something he didn't commit. The mayor's in the hospital. Someone caused this. It has to stop. I know it's him. The technology that was in that egg would have been around his prime. He kept on bringing up the incidents in his speech. It has to be him.
Fred, I admire your passion for finding the culprit, but at the moment, there's only vague links to it being him. You can't be sure based on a gut feeling. Go to sleep. It will help clear your head.
Can you text the others that I think I found a lead? I need to redeem myself for how I treated them, especially Velma.
As long as you start functioning normally, Fred. Please, I'm worried about you. We are, all are. Just get some rest. You deserve it.
Well, I have done it. The museum's down. The mayor's out. They all love me. It's all mine. I just have one final score to settle. I'll go to the owner of that godforsaken museum and show him what for. It's what he deserves. He shouldn't have tried to keep that all to himself. I know his ultimate motive now. And instead, I'll take it all for myself.
Did you get any response from them yet?
Yes. Velma said she'd be over with Shaggy, Scooby, and Nikki in a few hours to help discuss.
Sounds like a plan.
So you found a lead, Fred?
Yeah, I have a theory. So you remember Nikki saying that the soldering looked old?
You took on her advice in the end, huh?
Yeah. Sorry for turning you down, Nikki.
It's okay, Fred. I forgive you. Now let's solve this mystery. So what were you saying?
Well, I saw something on the TV last night, and I think we might have a suspect. But there's no solid proof. Velma, we might need you to help do a background check on this guy.
Like, what makes you think it could be him? He seems okay to me.
He says that he has an engineering degree. He also brings up the incident of the museum in Town Hall. It's not enough, but I feel like he's emotionally manipulating people into voting for him. This is where I need all of you to help. Any signs that point to him, report them to me. Background checks, things on the egg. Any evidence, bring it forward.
Got it, Fred!
is him! It should have been so obvious!
It's okay, Fred. We're not out of time yet. The live announcement isn't until 1 hour.
Making an extensive presentation on him?
Then we'll have to finish it off in the mystery machine. Shaggy, how long will it take to get to the Preposterous Island's prestigious theater?
Like 10 minutes by the car, man! We have enough time!
Great! Velma, get to work on the presentation. Everyone else, prep the mystery machine.
Oh, I've always wanted to ride in the mystery machine.
Okay, hair, suit, tie.
Right you do, Don. Now then, to the stage, I assume?
Hold it, Don!
This is being recorded on public television. What do you think you're doing?
Showing the truth.
We can, like, prove that Don Bacon did the two things that resulted in the mayor and the museum owner being put in the hospital.
Bring it, you meddling birds.
Gladly.
All in all, Don M. Bacon is a 2006 university graduate who has experienced pyrotechnics and engineering. He had a job as a demolition man until he was fired for controversial reasons. His only friend, J.P. Flywing, distanced from him as he was verging on psychopathy after firing from a previous job he had. And so, he decided to take the city for himself and act as a vengeance.
One thing you do not know, punk, is you will be in the hospital with them. I will kill you. I will destroy your family and everyone you love.
Well, we survived all of it.
Thanks for convincing me to go on this trip, guys. This island would have been doomed otherwise. The trip itself felt a bit abrupt and rushed, but I feel like I gained something from it.
Aww.
Dooby dooby doo!